Well, the phrase murder hornet is something that is one of the common names associated with the more typical common name, Asian giant hornet. And it doesn't murder people, it doesn't murder animals. What it does is that it destroys honeybee colonies.
Their bodies are at least an inch and a half, maybe 2 inches long. Their wingspan could be up to 3 inches long. And they'll attack almost anything if they think their nest is being attacked. So, and they have a capacity to do a lot of damage.
The honeybee colony is defended by 30 to 50,000 workers. But the workers can't sting this giant, Asian giant hornet. It just has too tough of an exoskeleton. And the hornet also has the ability to just bite the head off of a honeybee.
It just seems a little more gruesome by the size that you're dealing with. There are a lot of questions about how this insect has made it to the United States or to North America. And it's not clear because they don't have, they certainly didn't come across and punch a passport or do anything like that. There's some evidence that one of the initial introductions was caused just accidentally by some packing materials that contained a queen.
They seek a dark, warm hiding place to pass the winter. And so something like a shipping container that you would see on the large cargo ships is just an ideal location. And they get inside those, and then in a couple of weeks, they're over to the Pacific Northwest.
One of the reasons the task force came together was there was a lot of desire on the part of the state. The governor recognized it immediately. The state ag commissioner recognized the importance of beekeeping, and especially to the state's economy, but also the nation's economy. And they asked, Texas A&M and AgriLife to look into it. We hope we won't see it in the state, but to the extent that beehives from this state travel around to pollinate the fruit crops up there, there's a chance that you could be bringing something back. But the awareness of it is something that we want to make sure that we're not going to be caught with any kind of surprise.
The next step of the task force is to reassess if this insect becomes established in North America, in other words, in Washington State, and then we see movement out of the upper part of that state, the more northwestern corner of Washington State. How is that movement occurring? What is the likelihood of products coming from that part of the state into the southern U.S.? Because the southern U.S. is where this insect could thrive quite well.
We're lucky to have the kind of resources, the expertise here at the university. And the idea that they can and have embraced, kind of the concerns about this Asian, giant hornet so quickly and so effectively is a good testament to the quality of what Texas A&M AgriLife have to offer.